Hi, everybody. Today is April 28th. It's Tuesday. It is day two. So this is the work that we're doing today, just in case you don't have your packet yet, but you should. So right now, we're going to focus on our literacy, and that means that we're reading A Pumpkin Grows. So we, right now, are about to start our unit on plants. And I want you to take a second and think, what do you know about plants? And what do you wonder? What questions do you have? Pause the video, write those things down. It can be in your notebook, and then take a photo and send it to me, okay? And I'll stick it in our next one. But for right now, we're gonna be reading this book called A Pumpkin Grows. All right, my friends? So it's A Pumpkin Grows by Linda D. Bullock and illustrated by Debbie Fisher. A pumpkin grows. Where do pumpkins grow? Pumpkins can grow on farms. They can grow in gardens too. How do pumpkins grow? All pumpkins grow from seeds. Have you seen these seeds while carving your pumpkin? Where can you get pumpkin seeds? You can get them from a store or from inside the pumpkin. Some pumpkins are big, some are little. They all have seeds inside. In the spring, it is time to plant pumpkin seeds. It's spring right now. Too bad we can't work in our school garden. A new plant is inside each seed. It needs the sun to grow. It needs soil and water too. So this is a pumpkin seed, what it looks like on the outside. And if you opened it on the inside, you would see a new plant getting ready. After it rains, the seed grows a little sprout. All summer, the sprout grows and grows. It grows into a vine. Flowers grow on the vine. Bees fly in and out of the flowers. A flower grows into a pumpkin. The pumpkin gets bigger and bigger and bigger. Inside the pumpkins, seeds are growing. They get bigger and bigger too. In the fall, the pumpkin is ready to pick. The seeds are ready too. Seeds grow sprouts. Sprouts grow into vines. Vines grow flowers. Flowers grow into pumpkins, and pumpkins are full of seeds. Every fall, you can see big orange pumpkins. This is what we just read. Where do they come from and how do they grow? In one of our texts last week, I think it was last week, we read about the butterfly life cycle and how a cycle is something that happens over and over again. So you can see how this goes from seeds to sprouts, to vines, to flowers, to pumpkins, and back to seeds. I did want to show you really quickly just some pictures. I'm going to try and zoom in. Here we go. So these are different kinds of plants, and plants can be little. Plants can be trees. Plants have flowers and fruit like we saw before, and leaves. We get all sorts. This is a hydrangea bush, but this is ivy. We get all sorts of different kinds of plants, and they grow so much. Here are seeds that looks like sunflower seeds. This is a whole bunch of different seeds. I see pumpkin seeds, maybe almonds, I don't know. These seeds we would be eating. But these are seeds that somebody is planting, and those seeds will sprout just like that pumpkin seed did. Seeds can also be big, like this pit inside the avocado. Or if you've ever blown on a dandelion and these things all puff off, those are also seeds. You've got pomegranate seeds, that's just filled, and also apple seeds. We don't eat the apple seeds, but we do eat the pomegranate. So that was all that I wanted to share with you today. I want you to think about, what do you know about plants? What questions do you have about plants? And what have you learned about plants just in this video so far? And also, what does a plant need to grow? We read it in the pumpkin textbook, in the pumpkin book. There were three things that we read about. So what are those three things that a plant needs to grow? I hope you guys are having a good time planting your own plants. Don't forget to draw your pictures today of what it's looking like and write down your observations. And we'll keep going as we watch those plants grow. See you guys tomorrow.